Oh, yes, at Lily Bar and Lounge inside the Bellagio. I've been there. It's a very nice spot. You know, a lot of times if you don't want to do the club scene, it's just a nice, upscale, classy lounge where you can just have a nice drink and hang out with friends. So, listen, they have this world-class mixology program, which is kind of cool. I like that. So joining us in studio, Tim Weigel and David Brewer. Thank you, gentlemen, both, for being here.
Thank you.
We're
Thank
starting
you.
Our Friday off on a good note, huh? Get it going. Okay, so I want to talk about this mixology program. Can anyone take part in this?
Sure, definitely.
Oh, okay, yes, talk about it.
We have seasonally fresh ingredients, incorporate some really unique esoteric ingredients as well. So it's a great mix to the to Lily Bar and Lounge.
Nice, nice. So, I mean, basically, anybody who's looking to try, you know, something new to kind of tintillate their taste buds, so to speak, they can do that with what you guys are serving up, right?
Definitely.
Okay, cool. And so, David, let's talk a little bit about, you know, just kind of the ambiance that you guys like to create there and kind of what you want, you know, your patrons to experience when they come in.
We're looking to do an upscale environment and create an experience that every guest that comes into the Bellagio walks away wanting to come back for more.
Okay, that's always good. You know, leave them wanting a little bit more, mm-hmm. right? So they keep coming back. So, okay, so let's get on it. I want to see how what we're mixing up here, how the pros do it. And am I going to help you out? Is that what I...
If you'd like to,
okay.
Sure. Yeah, do you feel comfortable doing this?
Sure, I don't want to mess it up, but you know, I'll do my best.
I'll have you make this one. It's really
Ooh,
nice.
Okay,
it's
what's
called
this
Some
one?
Like It Bitter. So kind
Some
of a play
like
on
bitter.
The old Marilyn Monroe movie,
yeah.
Some Like It Hot, Some Like
very
It Bitter.
Nice. So, you know, before we go into that, just very quickly, when you say all the new, you know, stuff you're coming out with, so about how many new, like, drinks or things are you kind of coming out with?
Yes, 13 new cocktails.
13 new cocktails. Wow. Yes. Okay. So let's get going. Let's have
Sounds
a little
good.
Fun.
All right. So we're going to do two dashes of Peychaud's bitters.
Oh, okay. A little bitters here. One, two. Is that enough?
That would be
more?
Plenty.
Okay.
Excellent.
That's plenty.
Sounds
Not too
good.
Bitter, right?
So are you familiar how to use a jigger?
I am not, but I can learn
That's
today.
Right.
Okay.
Case hold in hand, and you're going to fill all the way to the top with Aperol.
Goodness. Okay.
This is going to provide the bitter component.
Okay, so this makes it even more bitter.
There we go. Just a touch more.
Just a touch more. Okay.
Just a touch.
We
want to.
Like there's a little stronger. That's okay too.
Here and we go. This? Next ingredient is italicus. So we're gonna do an ounce. You're gonna fill it all the way to the top.
To the top. Okay. How am I doing?
You're doing well.
Do you think I can, you know, get a gig moonlighting over there at Lily's Lounge?
Hey, you know what? Anything is possible.
He said anything is possible. I don't know.
We'll have to work on your technique a little bit, but that's all right.
Okay. Very good. Okay. What else do we have here?
So we're gonna do an ounce.
I'm gonna let you keep going because they have about 45 seconds or
Got
so.
It.
Okay.
Right here.
Since you go a little faster. Faster than I do.
Pink peppercorn Belvedere vodka. So we infuse some pink peppercorn.
Peppercorn. That's an interesting flavor, right?
Yes, definitely. It provides a nice citrus profile to the cocktail. And an ounce and a quarter of sake. So it dries
sake.
Out the cocktail. It's nice,
very
subtle
nice.
Notes to it.
Okay, while we're doing that, we're going to go to break, but we're going to come back with more of Lily Lounge at the Bellagio, kind of show you what the finished product looked like and tell you a little bit more about what you could experience. Stay with us. We are watching a mixologist at his craft here. Now, what are we pouring? Letters from Paris?
This is a letter from Paris.
Ooh.
Yeah, definitely an Armagnac cocktail.
Well,
so
you can send that to me anytime.
Definitely.
Come on, send
Very
it. I like
fresh.
It. Beautiful color too, right?
Definitely, yeah. My mother used to make fresh rhubarb pie when we were a kid, and there's actually a rhubarb influence on this cocktail. So
that's fascinating.
My inspiration behind this cocktail. So
Look
it uses Armagnac, which is a very unique esoteric ingredient. You don't see it a lot, but it has a nice, robust flavor to it.
And you guys have a couple drinks over here that you're
Correct.
Showcasing. Lucky for You, which is more
Lucky
of a tart
you.
Flavor, you said.
Yes.
Beautiful color, too. And then the Moscow Mule, of course, we know
yes.
what that's all about. And if I'm not mistaken, my history could be wrong, but it's you think of Moscow, you think of Russia, but it's actually from a town in Ohio? Moscow Mule, is that where
it Yeah, it was actually created here in America.
That's so interesting. Hey, check out Lily's Lounge, open daily, 5 p.m., Tuesday through Thursday. Well, they're open every day. Check them out. Bellagio, a lot of fun.